And now, it's time to sit back and enjoy the Two True Freaks Internet Radio Broadcast.
Fox Kids is what?
Fox Kids is Zeo powered up.
Welcome to another episode of Ranger Chronicles. I am your host, Charlie Neymar, and this time out, we are once again back in 1996 for two more episodes of Power Rangers Zeo. And just so you know, they are a small problem and oily to bed, oily to rise. So we're going to jump right into our first episode. I have my DVD queued up. This is also available on Netflix, as well as plenty of other DVD options. So we're going to get things kickstarted here in 3, 2, 1, go! A Small Problem first aired on September 19, 1996 and was the 28th episode of Power Rangers Zeo, written by Mark Hoffmeyer and directed by Vicky Bronaw. Bugs.
All right, let's see. We'll need some more sand, rocks, and some plants.
Maybe we can capture some desert wildlife like lizards or spiders or something.
Now the opening seemed okay, but now that we're in the episode, I'm seeing the bad footage stuff.
Hey, what's with the paint?
Well, I thought while you're out in the desert collecting stuff with Raymond, I'd paint the background to the terrarium.
And I got everything we need to collect all kinds of cool stuff. Maybe even a spider.
All right, well, we got the terrarium.
Oh, your hair got long.
Can you help me?
Sure.
The cat. Be careful out there, okay? Hey, what could possibly go wrong in the desert?
Oh, yeah. Right.
So you've invented a device that grows monsters bigger than orbises, eh?
What's the matter, Clank? Don't you believe me? They'll be more than big. They'll be enormous.
See?
Hey!
Whoops.
Where'd my rock go?
That's not bigger.
What a pity it didn't work. Oh, instead of enlarging it.
He shrank it almost out of existence. That'll teach him.
Maybe you don't know everything after all.
You take that back. It'll work, you'll see.
Ooh.
Ah, Sprout, my boy. There you are. How goes it with the new invention?
Well, it seems the young prince has produced the exact opposite of the effect he was looking for.
Are you telling me that instead of finding a way to make things grow, you actually made them shrink?
Yes.
You're
an absolute genius. Yes. Instead of increasing the size of our monsters, we'll decrease the size of the Rangers.
Uh-oh.
What's all this stuff? Ever hear Old Man Murphy?
The crazy man that was looking for the gold out in the desert?
Yeah. His granddaughter hired us to look through his old notes to see if he really had discovered the mother lode.
I don't think it had anything to do with his mother.
No,
probably not.
The mother lode is the richest vein of gold in the whole United States. And we're gonna find it. Come on, let's get this stuff together and head out to that old man's mine to get started.
I can dig it.
Get it.
Funny
as a cave-in.
Come on.
That's a lot of dust. Oh. That ain't gonna work. Go very well. He's got a different car now. Now he drives a black Jeep.
Yeah.
Which I guess technically is more in fitting with what he drove on it. Dino Thunder, but still.
Hey, can you give me a hand?
Sure.
Alright, let's get this out.
Careful, guys.
Gee, this looks like a familiar area.
Alright.
Okay, Cap. I want you to use this, see if you can collect some plants. Tommy, you can try and get some lizards, maybe even a spider with that.
Right.
I know you guys remember that old mine we saw. I'm gonna go see if I can dig up some cool stuff over there, okay?
Right.
Okay. All
right,
see you guys later.
See you, man.
Yeah, so this guy is really good at computers and bugs.
Look.
Oh. I bet you they don't catch. Told you. Take your time.
Look out.
Oh, it's gonna be a long way home.
Oh man.
Oh, I think we found the necessity for the black.
Jeez.
I was gonna say they need a morph. They're really lucky that that other kid's, like, gone.
Oh, leave them and try their places.
You're so cute.
You stay away from us.
We're gonna get out of here.
Can I keep them, please, Dad? I'll take real good care of them.
Why not? They can't cause much harm now.
Gee, thanks, Dad. Come on, my beauty power pets. I know just the perfect place to put you. This terrarium you brought will be perfect for your new home.
Oh, jeez.
Sprocket, don't do this. Let's go.
You guys stay here while I go find more pets to add to my collection.
All right, Sprocket.
Technically, can't they just teleport out?
Remember what happened last time when you forgot to give them water?
Tanya. Tanya and Catherine just left me out in the desert.
What?
Yeah, they just took off. I had to walk back. You seen them?
No, and this doesn't sound like something they do.
I know.
I better try to call Tanya's house.
Okay.
Why don't you call
Tanya? Tommy, Catherine, come in.
Oh.
Tommy, Kat, this is Tanya. Can you hear me? Zordon, come in.
Too small for their signal.
I think Tommy and Kat are in trouble.
I'll alert the other ranger.
Okay, tell them to meet me at the old Murphy mine.
Be careful, Tanya.
Look over there.
Wait a minute. Shouldn't have Zordon noticed.
Hey, it looks just like Tommy's truck.
That's a Jeep.
I wonder what could have happened. We better take it to Zordon.
They kept their backpacks on the whole time, and they don't notice this.
Yeah. You two are my pets. I'll keep you for as long as I want.
Come back and let us out of here.
He's not gonna let us go, Kat. We gotta find a way out before he gets back. Zordon, come in. Zordon. Looks like our power shrunk right along with our size. Our communicators don't even have enough power to reach Zordon. Man.
Then we'll have to do this on our own. Tommy. Look, up in the corner! There's a hole in the wire mesh!
Well, it won't be easy. But if we can make it up to the top of the terrarium, we might be able to escape. Yeah. This could be our only chance. Let's go.
Well, it's definitely their vehicle. I can even read the license plate. Somehow it's been molecularly miniaturized.
Well, what happened to Tommy and Catherine?
A complete scan of the area has not located their homing beacons.
Well, if they've been shrunken too, then their homing signals are going to be diminished as well. Well, we need to get back out there and look for them. Right.
On it.
Tommy, it seems so high. Do you think we can make it?
We have to try.
Hello, pets are back! Isn't this me? Oh! You weren't trying to escape now, were you?
No, of course not.
Because then you wouldn't get to play with a new playmate,
I guess.
Tommy, what are we gonna do?
His name's Harry, and he wants to give you a big hug.
What a way to go. Spider food.
Okay, I have to say that the effects here are actually fairly believable here.
Cat, you distract him. I have an idea.
Okay.
Wish me luck.
Yoo-hoo, Harry! I'm here!
I think
they definitely sound like a couple members of the Chipmunks. What?
Scream and run away.
Oh, that was good.
Tommy, it's time to climb over the barricade.
I know, but there's nothing more we can do. We gotta get out of here.
But how?
Carefully.
Skull, where are you? Skull! I know you went this way! Skull!
Whoa. Why is he running from a Power Ranger?
If something doesn't happen quick, we're done for.
Here. Huh? Let me give you a hand.
I was wondering where the Gold Ranger was going to play.
What do you think you're doing with my pet?
You shouldn't take things that aren't yours. See ya.
Why, you Iota.
Okay, you guys should be safe over here.
Sure.
You got here just in time.
Yeah, thank you.
No problem. The pleasure was all mine.
Now we get some Gold Ranger fun. Time for some backup. Tanya totally missed.
Well, don't stop now, Cox. I was just getting started. Come on.
Wait, you're not fighting fair.
Looks like they've got everything under control now.
So I'm just gonna step off camera and we're good to go.
Now it's your turn, Sprocket.
Think I hear my mommy call.
I knew he'd disappear when the going got tough.
Has anybody seen Tommy and Cat?
There they are. Over there.
Hey, guys.
We have a little bit of a problem here.
So we see.
You gotta get us back to Zordon.
Don't worry. You'll be there in no time.
Right. Hey, what's the matter, Tanya? Something wrong?
No, it's nothing. I was just wondering who the Gold Ranger was and where he went. And how he always seems to know when we need his help.
The spider was
always
to eat him when
both times.
I got in the way.
Don't worry. We have a little surprise for you. Clank?
Yes, indeed. Prince Sprocket, allow me to introduce you to your very own Tarantabot.
Ugh.
Cool, my own Tarantula Terminator! Just wait till those power dweebs meet him!
Sprocket shrank us with some kind of ray and put us in the terrarium.
Yeah, we're about to be lunch for a spider. But the Gold Ranger saved us.
Alright, now the effects don't seem quite as good.
Sorry, I'm just a little jumpy.
The shrinking is the result of the tightening of the spaces between the molecules of the object. But I should be able to spread them out using this molecular respacer. Just keep your fingers crossed.
Yeah, sure. Well, that works.
Is incredibly fierce. It must be confronted by the whole team.
We have to get Tommy and Catherine back to normal size.
Billy, you must proceed slowly. The molecular respacer has only proven itself safe on inanimate objects.
Little buddies, you better sit down.
Yeah, you might break the table if you're standing. Well, way to go slow there, Billy. That was the exact same speed as the Jeep.
Hey, thanks, Billy. You're welcome. That was definitely one of my biggest challenges. I'm just glad I figured it out.
So are we. Feels great to be back to normal. We gotta get going.
Yeah, thanks.
Back to action!
Ooh! What about the others?
And fire! Oh dear, it looks as though he needs our help, doesn't it?
Oh, that was terrible.
And away we go! Watch out! That monster's not gone yet!
It shouldn't be much of a problem though, right? I mean, they just took it out pretty quick. In normal size. I wonder if this would be the introduction of the Ultra Zord.
Let's squash this spider.
Right. Time for me to start spinning my web.
Yeah. That's not a web. That's a net. That was... I think I'm right. I could be wrong, actually. They could still not be free. Or they'll free them.
Power Rangers, listen quickly. I'm transmitting data to you showing that we can join our swords together to form one Zord, the Zeal Ultra Zord. There's a designated space for each of your Zords within my structure. Joined together, we are 10 times more powerful than any one of us alone.
That's great, but if he comes from another planet, and these Zords were created by Billy and Alpha, how is that possible? It's like this thing was designed to hold the other Zords. But it they should have known. I mean, headache. Nice. At least he's in the shade now. Where is Skull? Hey, look!
Foggy! Where have you been? What were you doing out here?
I needed some fresh air.
Not in California.
This looks really good, you guys.
Yeah, man, it sure is great to be looking at the terrarium from the outside.
Tommy, Catherine, why'd you guys leave me out in the desert?
We're really sorry, Raymond.
We get all turned around. And we were driving out there for hours. Look, we're sorry, man.
Okay. All right, well, I guess I needed the exercise anyway. Check this out. We got the perfect thing that'll finish off the terrarium.
Spider.
Ta-da!
I saw that coming.
Where have you been? I've been looking all over for you two.
For your information, we've been making the discovery of the century. We have been finding
Old Man Murphy's book. He means the mother lode, sir. You know, gold. We're gonna be rich. Rich! Rich! We got sacks and sacks of it!
It's only appropriate that you two fools would spend an entire day digging up a bunch of worthless iron pyrite. Fool's gold. Fool's gold.
Nicely done, boys. All right, and that's going to do it for this one. We're going to take a quick break. I'll play a commercial, and we'll come right back with our second episode.
When the going gets tough, it's time for reinforcements. When the enemy gets stronger, it's time for more power. When the clouds of danger approach, it's time for a new hero. Soon every cloud will have a gold lining. Catch an all-new Power Rangers Zeo today after Big Bad Beetleborgs on Fox Kids.
All right, and we're back. And we're going to get into our next episode, which is Oily to Bed, Oily to Rise. And we're going to get that started here in 3, 2, 1, go. Oily to Bed, Oily to Rise was the 29th episode of Power Rangers Zeo. It first aired on September 20th, 1996, written by Giles Wheeler and directed by Robert Redler. Ooh, surfing. Of course, Stone Canyon. Hey, Rocky's still a lifeguard, except now he wears blue shorts.
You think the Gold Ranger knows how to surf?
I never really thought about it, Rock.
Think about it, though. He could be standing right near us, and we wouldn't even know it.
Yeah. Hey, guys. Hey.
Hey! Hey,
thanks for coming aboard, Tommy. Well, I better get ready. My heat's up next.
Hey, I never knew you were into surfing, David.
There's a lot of things you don't know about me, bro.
Well, he's even got a bit of a goatee going. Oh, see how they're teasing that he could be the Gold Ranger?
But swimming looks fun if only it was machine sludge instead of water.
Why, that's it. Sprocket, you're a genius. We'll transform all the Earth's water into machine sludge.
Not only will we take care of those bothersome humans.
That should be easy.
We'll establish the perfect environment for our machine army.
I could handle that if you want me to.
Nicky Fawcett. He is the logical choice, dear.
Well.
Besides, he's already.
Didn't we already see him?
Oh, all right. Clank, go with him and make sure by the end of the day every source of water on that planet is contaminated.
Yeah. Oh, no, I guess it's similar, but not exactly the same.
So far, it's been a pretty tough contest, with most of the servers running neck to neck.
Here comes the set out the back. Cat Hilliard's looking one over. She's paddling.
Whoa. Well, she is pretty good.
Listen up.
Whoever
it's
that
not
is.
That complicated. This is a diagram of the Angel Grove water system. Just enter the pipes and release your toxins. Understand?
Piece of cake.
And stay inside the pipes. Remember, you're not allowed to leak out on your own.
Ready or not, here I come.
Oh dear, I'm sure to rust now.
Yes, sirree. A piece of cake.
Okay.
Mail call. Great. My Java of the Month selection.
Oh. Java.
From the looks of it, a rare Jamaican bean. Ben, it's time for you to learn the most important skills of a first-class private eye. How to make a good cup of joe.
In the know
there's a book.
Joe. A coffee lover's handbook written by Jerome B. Stone.
Hey, that's you! Well, you don't miss a trick, do you, Skolnitch? Get to it, boys. Make those pages come to life.
Yes, sir.
One perfect cup of joe coming right up.
Okay, I will say coffee smells good. Usually.
All right, it says here that the first thing we need is fresh, clean water.
Uh-oh.
Fresh, clean water.
Yeah.
How's it coming, gentlemen?
Just fine. No problem, sir. We're just good.
Why can't they tell him that the water's messed up? Oh, that's a good waste of... Oh, Beavis and Butthead reference. Nice. Ooh, she's getting good.
Good job, Adam.
Thanks, but we better get going. We got a lot left to do today.
Can we please have a drink first?
Yeah, I need some too.
Hey, Ernie. 2 aguas, please.
No problemo.
No, my style is just it's not right.
Well, we'll keep working on it tomorrow.
What world?
Ernie, when's the last time you cleaned out that hose?
Man, I gotta wash this out. This is really weird.
Ooh.
Ugh. I don't know, Ernie. It looks pretty gross.
There's gotta be something wrong with the pipes. I'm gonna go check in the back.
I know that smell.
Smells like cog oil.
Oh.
Final heat of the day, surfing fans. 2 minutes to go. Cat Hilliard needs one more successful ride to take the lead.
One more wave. She's got this thing wrapped up.
Let's go, Cat!
Oh, but the... Oh.
You're right, Adam. It's the same stuff used to power the cogs, and it's definitely toxic. If it gets on anybody, or worse yet, if anybody drinks it, the results are going to be disastrous.
What's going on, Alpha?
Uh-oh. The bulk of skull is using it as a coffee.
Cogs, it looks like they're trying to release that toxic goo into the ocean.
Ready, Tanya?
You bet.
That's kind of where, Cat is right now, too, huh? You know, I could be wrong, because they're doing that same motions that usually Tommy only does.
Nice try, metalheads.
Even without Tommy around, so maybe... Just not sure what hand motions they want to do for this.
You want this? You're gonna have to go through me!
Uh-oh. Adam, where the heck are you? Oh, he's over there dealing with one cog.
Adam!
Oh my goodness, it looks like... Ugh. Man, bad CGI. Uh-oh.
It's too late, it's in the water!
Oh no! The current's carrying us south towards the competition. Zoran, show Tommy to get everyone out of the water.
I sure hope Billy's come up with the neutralizer.
Yeah.
We better get back to the power chamber.
Yeah!
Oh, just in time for cats. Ew.
Check that out. What the? What's happening?
Cat better be getting out of the water.
Tommy, you must clear the beach area. King Mondo is converting the world's water supply into highly toxic cog oil. It will destroy anything it comes in contact with.
Hey, don't you guys think it's time for a visit from the Power Rangers? There's too many people watching. Rocky, take care of those people on the beach. David and I will get Cat out of the water.
Right.
Ready?
Just call out to her. I guess she doesn't have her communicator. Swimming, obviously.
This is all going along very well indeed.
Very well indeed, yes.
And the best part is those pesky power punks are too busy to get in our way.
Just think, my dear. Every drop of water turned into sludge.
Because nothing survives without water, and the planet will be ours.
Get this thing fixed.
Strange activity was reported today at the water treatment plant.
Then come see this.
Angel Grove residents are...
In a minute, sir, we're, in a delicate phase of the Java-making process.
As you were, then.
Details are a bit sketchy at the moment.
As we were. Yeah, right. What does this have to do with detective work?
Remember, Bulky, it's about detail!
What are you talking about? This is a disaster! I'm exhausted.
There is some sort of
stressed
at the Angel Grove water treatment plant.
And thirsty.
Angel Grove residents are encouraged to drink only bottled water until the safety of the city's water has been verified. Meanwhile, on a happier note.
Meanwhile, on a happier note.
Over here.
What is it? What's wrong?
Quick, you gotta get out of the water.
What are you talking about?
I'll explain later.
Uh oh.
David, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm okay.
Yeah, where's Cat? Oh, you can even still see some of the green though.
Cat. I don't see her anywhere.
There she is. Wow, she is so pale compared to them.
Just a little disoriented.
Come on. We gotta get out of here.
What is that?
That's what I've been trying to tell you. Come on, just kick this boat ashore.
Kick fast, guys.
I knew there was more to this than just cogs. Check it out, guys.
Leaky faucet! That slime spreader.
Yeah, well, this one's a much more lethal version.
Good work, Billy. If this
he said lethal.
Completes his toxic task, all life on this planet will be in great danger.
The computer shows Angel Grove's toxic levels are headed out of sight.
Listen, I'll stay here with Alpha and work on an antidote, and then I'll contact the others, okay?
Effect to it. All right.
Well, you guys are out of shape. Just kidding.
Go ahead, Zordon. We read you.
Rangers, Billy has determined that by destroying the leaky faucet monster, the spell will be broken and the water will return to normal.
We're on it, Zordon. Hey, David, you gonna be okay? Hey, where'd he go?
Huh.
We don't have time, Tommy. He'll be okay.
Yeah.
Can they still morph now?
It's morphin' time!
Boo's going, Tane will get you 20. The Gold Ranger will be there. I don't think it's David. So that's right. It's just a different version of the same monster. The difference is he doesn't have the thing on his head.
Hey, this is getting fun!
I told you you're not allowed to leak out on your own. Eliminate those rangers and finish your job. The fountain! Activate the fountain!
Okay.
Man, he liquefied and got back into the water system. Quick, activate the tracking volume meter. Adam, is it working?
I'm on. What?
How about you, Tanya?
All set here.
All right, boss of face. Just try and get doing? Away.
Yeah, gotcha. Sorry, pal. End of the line.
Adam, close your sight down, too. Right.
Stupid power pumps thought they could catch me. Hey, what's going on? They closed the pipe down. No matter, I'll go down this way.
Adam, he's headed back towards you.
Oh, no, you don't. It's time to flush out the pipe.
I'll get him when he comes out.
Right.
Where'd he go?
He's gone.
They fall for it every time.
He's over there.
Hey there, fellas. I sure could use a little help.
Hold it.
Oh wow. I'd be a little scared up there.
I think it's time to finish
this. Oh, he does have the. Huh. I want to say last time though, he had it over the hat.
Say bye bye, Power Rangers! Oh, come on! Give me your best shot! Sorry, guys, not a scratch!
We didn't even touch him!
Oh, did he just do a ninja move?
Is everyone alright? We have to find a way to stop him. That's it! Freon! We can freeze him solid! Everybody follow me! Come on!
Alright.
Hey, guys, where are you going? Funny, I could have sworn they came this way!
Alright, attention.
Did he put his hat back on? What?
As soon as he liquefies, hit it.
Bye! Fire!
He is doing ninja move.
Your toxic spewing days are over!
Now that's teamwork.
Did you see that, Albus? They turned him into a giant...
Nicely done, Ranger.
I say he needs our help!
Around and around and away!
Although I feel like I should be talking like this. Well done, Rangers! But be prepared for the need of your zords.
Looks like the shoe's on the other hand now.
We need your zord power now!
Red Battle Zord, power up now!
Oh, they're bringing out all their artillery. Jeez.
Wait a minute, what's all this?
Initiate the Ultra Zord sequence!
Wow, you're going to the heavy guns fast. I guess they just know that their other swords aren't going to work. I wonder if the fight's longer in O-Ranger.
Boy, look how big you've got.
That is huge. Why didn't turn to water there?
Almost ready,
dodge
sir.
Dodge this.
Oh, the water finally came back on. One cup of Joe ready to go.
I smell success. Let's have a slug.
Oh.
You do the honors, Detective Skolovich. Perfect.
Okay.
Those Power Rangers have done it again. Oh, when I finally get my hands on them, especially the gold one, I'll do hideous things to them.
Now, don't worry, dear. We have all the time in the universe, remember?
He won't.
Machines are forever.
That's right, Pop. Don't bust a bolt. We'll get them next time. Hey, Dad?
Yes, but I'd give a ton of steel to know exactly who the Gold Ranger is.
I think they all would.
Did David show up?
Oh, yeah, I haven't seen him. How weird.
Oh, hey, man, how's it going? You okay?
I'm fine. I just had a little something to take care of.
Okay, surfing fans, the moment we've all been waiting for. The judges have made their final decisions. And the winner in the Angel Grove catch-a-wave competition is Johnny Spencer!
I guess they don't always win.
Hey, maybe next time, huh?
Yeah, we want something more important today anyway. Clean water.
Hey, dudes, come on!
I'd take that over a trophy any day.
Yeah.
Aw, man. David got really tan, too. She's just sitting there. Going to do it for today's episode. I hope you all enjoyed those two. We got two more episodes lined up for next time, and they are Rockabye Power Rangers and Do I Know You? So we're going to watch those next time, and I hope you all have a great week, and I will see you soon. Bye, everybody.
Thank you for listening to Ranger Chronicles. Feedback for the show can be sent to prchronicles@gmail.com, or feel free to leave a comment at the show's posting at powerrangerchronicles.com. All images and music heard on the show are copyright their respective holders and are meant to help celebrate the Power Rangers. No infringement is intended. Power Rangers is copyright Hasbro Entertainment. This show is dedicated to all the men and women, both in front of the camera and behind the scenes, who have worked to bring us Power Rangers for over 25 years. Ranger Chronicles is a proud member of the Two True Freaks Internet Radio Network. Please be sure to stop by twotruefreaks.com to check out more great shows. Thanks again for listening, and good night. Oh,